Good morning, students. So welcome back. So last in two videos we have seen four different types of conic section: parabola, ellipse, hyperbola and circle. Circle obviously is not included in our syllabus. Then in second video I have already explained about the parabola, that is concave right parabola. Now under parabola we have concave right, left, up and down. So I'm going to explain only concave right and concave down parabola. In case of concave left and concave up, you have to do it as an assignment. So if you have understood the concept, if you focus here and listen carefully, definitely you can solve concave left and concave up parabola easily. So here, without wasting time, let's start with concave down parabola. So concave down parabola, the equation is given by x square equal to negative 4ay. So this is a concave down parabola. Now here, as I explained already in previous video, this point is called vertex. Now this type of parabola, which is a standard form of parabola, the vertex will be always at the origin. So therefore in this case also we have vertex at 0, 0. So therefore first point we have vertex at 0, 0. Next point we have focus. So focus, as I told you, it should be always inside the parabola. So therefore we have here focus. So let me take from again origin to this focus as a distance as a A. You cannot take distance negative A. Distance is never measured in negative. So say distance is A, but what is this point now? This point is nothing but point is negative A. So therefore, the focus point here in this case will be x coordinate will be 0 and y coordinate is negative A. This is a focus point. X definitely a point on the y-axis, so x value, x, that means the x-intercept here is equivalent to 0. So 0 and the y-coordinates we have here, y is equal to negative a. So focus point we have here s is 0, comma negative a. Now let's go with the equation of directrix. So please check same distance, same unit of distance, say here it is. So what will be this point now? Definitely this point becomes positive A. So if I draw a straight line, so definitely this becomes the directrix. So D dash. So now what will be the equation of the directrix? So you know this is nothing but y-axis. Now since the directrix is intersecting y-axis, so equation of directrix will be y is equivalent to, it's passing through point A, y is equivalent to A. Therefore equation of directrix is y is equivalent to A, or implies y minus A is equivalent to 0. This is the equation of directrix. Now let's go with the next point, that is the equation of axis. So in previous video I talked about equation of axis. Now so in this case, what's the equation of axis here? Equation of axis is y-axis, because y-axis is the line which is passing through the vertex. That's the definition of the axis. So axis is a line which passes through the vertex of the parabola. So therefore y-axis itself is the equation of the axis. So now since this parabola is lying on the y-axis, so equation of axis you are going to write is x is equivalent to 0, meaning it does not lie on the x-axis, it lies on the y-axis. Now let's go with the length of lattice rectum. Now length of lattice rectum remains same for all the parabolas. The length of the lattice rectum remains same. What's the length of lattice rectum? Length of lattice rectum, here it is. What's the length of lattice rectum? Is a line which passes through the focus. So I took this one as a 2a is a, what's a 2a? 2a is a nothing but it is a semi lattice rectum. So L2 L dash. So therefore, the length of lattice rectum is 2a plus 2a, it becomes 4a. Make sure we are talking about length here, 4a units. That's the length of lattice rectum. So length of lattice rectum will remain same in all the four parabolas, whether it's a concave right, left, up or down. So now let's go with the equation of lattice rectum. So now what's the equation of lattice rectum? This is a line which is passing through which point? It's passing through negative A. And it is intersecting what? It is intersecting y-axis. So therefore, equation of lattice rectum will be y is equal to negative A, which is always the opposite of the directrix, because the lattice rectum and directrix will be always in the opposite side, and the distance, I told you, it's always should be equal. Now very interesting here, one question, and in previous video also I talked something about eccentricity. Why the distance should be always equal? That's a question. I will give you a second, you can think about that one. Why the distance from vertex to focus and vertex to directrix should be equal? Why the distance should be always equal in case of parabola? Reason is very simple. I told you the ratio, modulus of SP divided by modulus of MP, which is a eccentricity in previous video, here is always should be equal. Then only the eccentricity value will be equal to 1. Doesn't matter what kind of parabola, the parabola eccentricity value is always equal to 1. Ellipse is less than 1, hyperbola is greater than 1. In case of circle, eccentricity value is equal to 0. So therefore, now in order to have eccentricity value 1, from vertex to focus and vertex to directrix should be always equal. So equation of lattice rectum y equal to negative a, now that implies y plus a is equivalent to 0. At last, what's the eccentricity value for this parabola? So definitely is equivalent to 1. So that's it for concave down parabola. And then please, you have to go on solving with concave left and concave what? Concave up parabola. So please do it yourself. That's an assignment. So from next video, from next session, we'll start solving problems on parabola. So if you have understood these four parabolas clearly, then only while solving problems there won't be any problem in solving the questions. And that's it. And then thank you very much. So we'll see in next video lesson. Thank you.